It's Christmas once again, and welcome to Casa Daza. We're doing our Christmas or holiday special potluck meals. Today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cook dishes or suggest dishes that you can bring for any potluck get-together. As you can see, I'm in this most beautiful cuisine experience and design studio here in Makati. And you know what? They're the distributor of Pogen Paul. Pogen Paul, to me, is the most beautiful kitchens in the world. Today, I have three recipes. What I'm going to do for my first recipe, I'm going to make a Philly chicken sandwich. No? Instead of beef, I'm going to use chicken. To put together a tasty sandwich, we will need boneless chicken thighs, oil, chopped garlic, chicken cubes, green pepper, red pepper, salt, pepper, onions, baguette-like bread, and butter. For the cheese sauce, we will use quick melt cheese, all-purpose cream, and finely chopped pimiento. Let's heat some cooking oil. Yeah, look at this, the design of this stovetop. Ganda-ganda, oh my gosh. Okay, while I'm waiting for our oil to heat up a bit, what I'll do is I'm going to make the sauce. The sauce is just actually made of cream. Yan. You know, I love this sandwich, so I tried to duplicate it. So anyway, cream, all-purpose cream, some quick melt cheese. You can use cheese sauce also. And then you just have some chopped pimiento. Okay. Yeah, just mix all of these together. The moment that melts, that becomes your cheese sauce. So we can set that aside. We start with garlic. We'll start sauté some garlic. Ayan. Okay, so we're not gonna brown the garlic. All we're going to do is just parang extract the flavor of the garlic. Okay. We add in some chicken cubes. You know, in the beginning, I thought, why add green and bell peppers? You know, it does work. I don't know if you've seen the way they make this in Philadelphia. Wow, grabe. It's so, so delicious. So I'm trying to duplicate this, but instead of using steak, I'm using chicken. Red and green bell peppers. Yan. And you know what else here is that I have some glazed onions. You know the onions that we use in making onion soup? That's what I have. Okay, so red and green bell peppers. Okay, I'm going to season this with salt and pepper. Yan. I'll mix our salt and pepper here. You know, people have different ways of putting mga flavorings. Me, I like to mix salt and pepper because at least that way you're distributing it very, very well. Okay, but you know what? The life of this sandwich is in the cheese sauce. And I have here chicken thighs, boneless chicken thighs. Okay, they're not chopped. So we will cook all of this until it's nice and done. Okay. Ako naman, let's go back to our cheese sauce. But you know, key actually is just taste, taste, taste. You have to taste. Okay, now let's go back to our chicken. Let's flip this over. You remember, compared to chicken breast, chicken thigh cooks longer. So you have to be very patient. You cannot have this medium rare. It has to be fully cooked. Yan. Actually, our cheese sauce is done. I'm going to set this aside. Let me taste it muna. Uy, okay siya. Come back to our chicken. And what I'll do here, the moment the chicken is done, you'll know also, you look at indicators to see how the chicken is doing in doneness. You look at it, if there's a little pinkish color pa, then it's still undone, no? You just have to flip it over, and you check it. You just press it with your cooking spoon, and there's a little firmness in chicken when it's done, okay? Okay, we'll come back to this one. The moment the chickens are done, I'm going to have this chopped, and then mix all the ingredients together, and I'll show you how to assemble this, okay? Okay, I've chopped some already. What I'll do is I'll chop the last two pieces, just like this, just so you have an idea what I'm doing. I'm just chopping it just like this one, and then put it back, because we want all the flavors of those bell peppers, remember? Yan. Mix this very, very well. Yan, look at that. Okay, and we are going to start assembling. I'll show you what we will do. Sarap yan. I have some butter. Okay, so we are going to just toast the outside of the bread. It's like a hot dog bread. You may use a hot dog bread if you don't want, or you may use a baguette, no? So we are going to just toast the outside. Lang, like this. Toast it. Yan. I want you to see this, no? Look at the crust that I put on that bread, no? Then, we're going to go for the inside naman. Yan. Butter. And the crust of the bread. Let's go. Just make a circular motion. It's like this one. Let's leave it for a while. Look at that. Huh? Look at that. Okay, now what we will do first is we will get some of our... Yung onions natin, let's heat it a little bit. These are glazed onions. What I did, I got maybe about 2 cups of onion rings and then some butter, and I just patiently fried it. Siguro mga 15-20 minutes until the sugars come out and it becomes this color. Okay. Ayan. So, try to imagine, there's going to be a little crunch, there's toast in the bread, there's a little sweetness in the onions. Okay, look at that. Then we're going to put our chicken. You know, you want to get a wider baguette, go ahead and do that, no? Look at that. You know, I get excited when I come up with something really good, and you're going to serve it with people who love to eat. Oh my. Okay. Then our cheese sauce. And our cheese sauce natin. Every bite, you'll have creamy, you'll have cheesy, you'll have crunch, you'll have deliciousness from the bell peppers. And the pimiento cheese. Look at that. And look at this. Then you close it like that. Yan na yun. Look at that. This is going to be so, so good. A Philly chicken sandwich. Fish Paupillette. Watch me prepare this recipe right here at Casa Daza. Every time you go to a potluck, it's about surprising the guests, diba? So you want to surprise them with something, of course, delicious and something different. This dish I came across when I lived in Paris long ago, no? This is called fish paupillette or paupillette. And what it is, it's fish that you wrap in foil or wax paper, and then you put different kinds of vegetables and herbs and spices. That when you bake it, this one is you bake it, and then you cut it, you know, the smoke will come out to you and talagang, they'll really surprise you. This is called fish paupillette or paupillette. For my fish paupillette recipe, we have blue marlin, dill leaves, salt, pepper, lemon juice, spring onions, celery, onions, carrots, garlic, lemon, white wine, and good extra virgin olive oil. Let's start this recipe. Let me just get my blue marlin and then season this with salt and pepper. So I have here salt and pepper. Okay, mix this together. I want the fish to be flavored even if there is no sauce, okay? So what we will do is season this with salt and pepper, flip the other side and do exactly the same. Yan. Yan. Okay, this is, you wanna talk about something unusual, this is it. So what we will do is set this aside. I have my blue marlin fillet, onions, okay. I have garlic. I have carrots. Are you wondering? Spring onions. Okay. We have some celery. And then some lemon juice. Okay. So maybe about 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. This I will mix all together well. And then I will season this with salt and pepper also. Okay, so that's flavored also. Okay. Yeah, now what we will then do is start assembling our fish cooked in wax paper. Okay, so we'll just cut some wax paper. Yeah, this is extra big, no? But okay, I have here my vegetable mixture. I'll add in some extra virgin olive oil. Okay, the aroma of olive oil is very good. Okay. And then what we will do is just lay some of these vegetables on the bed like this. Yan. Then what we will do is we'll put our blue marlin here. We're going to put some dill. You know, what will happen here is when you put the dill and you cook it and you cut the paper, all the vapor will come out to you and parang, whoa. It'll surprise you. And then we have some slices of lemon that we will put on top. Okay, just like that. And then we will add some white wine. Yan. Very little lang. All of this is just a blend of different kinds of aroma that when you put it together, parang woo, it'll come out, no? Okay. Let's do this, no? This is the way I'll try to wrap it. And lang, that's it. And then what you want to do is just put it on a baking dish just like this one. Okay. And I'll make another one so you have an idea what I'm doing. Okay. Wax paper. And then put the bed of vegetables on the base. You know, this mixture. Okay, so what we want to do is get our blue marlin. Put some dill. Remember, this is the one that the dill is kind of important, that's it, because this herb goes very well with seafood, you know. And there's a nice smell to this one. Okay, so our dill is there. Little white wine. Konti lang. And then our lemon slices. Okay. Sarap. Okay, so what we will do is fold the sides. Like this. Practice. You make a mistake, get more wax paper. Diba? Look at that. Yan. Yan na yan. And then what you want to do, just pick it up like this and put it on a baking dish. Okay? The moment all the ingredients start cooking, they'll blend together, and trust me, this is going to be so delicious. Let's bring it to the oven. We're just gonna bake this for about 20 minutes. Okay. Look at that. You know, our kitchen, it is so beautiful. Okay. And we'll wait for about 20 minutes and we'll come back to this one. For sure, this one is cooked. Okay. And let me just put this here. Yan. But don't forget to close the oven. Anyway, imagine this. You're in a party. You brought the Paupillette. You cooked it there. You brought it in front of all your friends. Your friends around. And what you want to do is just look at this. Remember, you have to cut it crosswise also. Eh? Yeah. Look at this. You know what? I can smell the dill and the lemon and the mirepoix, the mixture of the vegetables. And trust me, this one with tender and melt in your mouth, Blue Marlin, this is going to be a winner in any potluck. You have to try this. Fish Paupillette wrapped in wax paper. Trust me, it's different, it's delicious. Up next, I will show you how to make Cordon Bleu Spring Rolls. So stay tuned to learn this recipe on Casa Daza. Our last recipe for today is something that I would like you to surprise your potluck guests with, no? I got the idea when I was looking through Facebook, yung mga feed namin. Sabi ko, uy, ganda ng recipe na yun. So this one is called Cordon Bleu Spring Rolls. It's actually very easy to make. It's unique and it is delicious. To prepare Cordon Bleu Spring Rolls, we have chicken breast, ham, quick melt cheese, cream cheese, spinach, garlic powder, seasoning liquid, lumpia wrappers, and cooking oil. So here they are. These are the ingredients I have here. A blender. It's important that you have a blender, no? So I'm going to just put all the ingredients here. What I'll do is I'll put extra virgin olive oil, actually. But me, I like to put extra virgin olive oil. And the reason I'm using liquid or extra virgin olive oil, you have to put some liquid, eh? Otherwise, it's difficult for it to blend, no? When you have the chicken and all the solid ingredients, okay? Here I have chicken breast. Okay, these are filleted chicken breasts. You can include the skin if you like, but me, I chose not to. Okay. I have some sliced ham. Believe me, alam mo, when you have potluck dinners, every so often I have potluck dinners also with some of my friends or chefs. There's a silent competition na, you know, who comes up with something really good. Anyway, I have some cheese and cream cheese. Now, I have here spinach, okay? These are fresh spinach. Normally, what you do is you cook them, pero I will not because we're going to cook them the moment we wrap them in the lumpia wrappers. I have some garlic powder, okay? And then I have liquid seasoning. This is, will blend it. Actually, the cheeses are all flavored already, so this is added flavor lang. What I'm going to do is ground this together. Yeah, this one is done. Now, what you can do also, if let's say you don't have a blender, you can chop it up yourself. But you know, you have to have patience, slowly. And the advantage of chopping it instead of putting it in a blender, because it's really going to be ground, no? Chopping it, you will have chunks of chicken, you will have the cream cheese, you will have all the flavors. So when you bite into it, you can identify what you're biting into. As opposed to the other one, which sometimes I prefer, is when you blend everything together, parang, wow, this is so good, but you can't identify what the ingredients are. I personally like it like that. So what I'll do here is I'll put it in a bowl, put all our filling here. So like I mentioned, you can chop it or you can ground it. Okay, so let's mix this very, very well. Let's start wrapping. I have a chopping board here. Very important, you get a good quality lumpia wrapper. Okay, I'll just show you an example of how to wrap. This is a good quality lumpia wrapper. Okay. Tignan mo, it doesn't tear. Yeah, look at that. Now, you get a spoon, okay, and then dip it in some water so that the filling doesn't stick, and get siguro this much. Parang it's like making a, ano eh, lumpiang Shanghai. Look at that, oh. It's so good. Then what you want to do is go like this. Make sure it's tight. Okay. Yan. Look at that. Okay, I'm going to make a few. I have hot oil here, and we're going to start frying. But I'll make you another one. Dip it in water so that it doesn't stick. I can see the chunks of ano, yung cream cheese. Ooh, look at that. Look at that. And then, yeah, and you can use the wrapper to form the lumpia. Okay, fold the sides, just like this. Sarap nito. You know, you cannot make it too big also because, you know, you have to have that balance of ratio ng starch in the filling, di ba? If you make it too thick, then there's no balance anymore. Okay, we'll come back the moment I've wrapped everything. Yeah, okay, now, you know what some people do is to check the oil, if it's hot enough. Yeah, no, look at the bubbles, the back of the spoon. Okay, it's saying, I'm ready. Okay, so we'll start frying. Yeah, don't drop it all at the same time. Why? Because the temperature will drop of the oil and it'll lose its shocking effect. Okay, look at that. You know, trust me, you want to bring something to your potluck get-together, something unique and something different, this is it. You know what will happen here sometimes is you look at the lumpia wrapper, parang, it doesn't look golden enough. But what happens is that when you pick it up, it continues cooking, it ends up being golden brown. So there you go. I can imagine this is so good. This is done. Okay, this one is done. Okay, what you want to do is let it drip. So when you make it stand, it has to be slanted so that the oil drips on paper towel. Okay, so all we have to do is just plate this. Yan na, look at that. That's so good. Yan, look at that. They're beautiful. Yan, that's it. All I have to do is plate this. There you have it. This one is called Cordon Bleu Spring Rolls. It's unique, it's delicious. I have a fish paupillette. We have a Cordon Bleu Spring Roll. And of course, a Philly chicken sandwich. Tasting time! Favorite part ko ng show is tasting. Okay, what I've done is we have a Cordon Bleu Spring Roll. If you want to have it with ketchup or chili sauce, it's up to you. I have a fish paupillette using blue marlin and of course a Philly chicken sandwich, no? Okay, let's start with this one. Cordon Bleu Spring Roll. I can taste the ham, the chicken, the cream cheese, but in the crunch, you want some sauce? You know what else I can taste? I can taste the seasoning liquid. Between the two, I prefer without sauce. That way you can taste all the ingredients. Very good. Now, itong popiet natin yung fish. Blue marlin with the sauce. Let's get some of the sauces and the vegetables. You put this on top. And the dill. Dill is so good. You know, I love dill talaga. Okay. I love the aroma of dill. There it is. You know what jumps out? The lemon, the dill, and the white wine and the crunch of the vegetables. Very, very good. And it's different. And carrots are still crunchy. That's good. The last, but not the least, is our chicken steak. Buttered bread, okay, with our cheese sauce. And believe me, this is so, so good. You have to do this at home. Remember, these are our holiday potluck dishes. Before I go, I'd like to thank my friend, Happy Umpauko, for her beautiful plates, yung Happy Home ni. Alam mo, si Happy, every time you see her on television, parang she's so bubbly and joyful. And so are her plates. I'll see you again next time. Bye!